Us to the snowbound planet of Hoth. You might remember Hoth as the location of the Rebels' Echo Base, which was attacked by at the beginning of the Empire Strikes Back. As you can see, Hoth is a frigid planet. It's the sixth planet in a system of the same name. Ice and snow. This looks like some kind of storage tower, maybe fuel or something, probably belonging to the Rebels, and accompanying hardware with no obvious function, but in true Star Wars fashion, it's covered. Looks like there's some kind of a hose leading up the hill, maybe carrying fuel. Looks like there's a little bit of a shuttle up there, just peeking up. The Rebels chose the planet of Hoth for the location of their hidden base. Inhospitable, and I suppose they hoped that the Imperials wouldn't think to search here, but of course they sent probe droids out across the galaxy, thousands and thousands of them, to find the Rebels. Let's take a walk into this cave. So cold. Just the, again, the environmental details are stunning in these maps. The ice crystals that protrude from the walls of the cave, for instance, just make it feel cold. The Rebels, secret base into a series of ice caves, much like this one. What they didn't know was that these ice caves were already inhabited. They were inhabited by several different creatures. The first bipeds, which the Rebels actually ended up domesticating and using for transport on the planet. They're well adapted to the snowy conditions of the daytime surface of the planet. But the caves were also inhabited by Wampa creatures. ceiling. Looks like some remains of a wampa meal here, perhaps. A rib cage. It hung him from the ceiling, bound his feet in ice, and apparently that's a typical way in which wampas will save their meal for later. Luckily for the rest of the galaxy, Luke did manage to escape with the help of the Force. Stepping out of the cave now, snowflakes drifting down from the sky. We can hear the wind whistling across. Snow. You can see the sun is low in the sky, close to the horizon. Just gorgeous lighting in these environments highlights the footprints and the textures in the snow. This looks like an icy surface here. Just barely covered in sort of powdered snow. I love the ice. Look at the ice has a depth to it. You can see down into it almost. That is gorgeous. Stunning attention to detail. Just amazing. This other piece of wreckage here, see if it belongs to the same downed TIE fighter. And it definitely looks like it does belong to the same ship. This is the other wing solar panel. Distance up on the hill there, you can see that shuttle that we got a little glimpse of previously. I love the fire effects. Well done. And the wind, the way the snow blows across the surface. And the crunching. Footsteps that you hear. It's all so well done. It really feels genuinely frigid. Let's take a little stroll. Someone's been here and lit up the caves. Probably the rebels, I suppose. this beautiful late afternoon lighting just perfectly capturing the feel of the movies. The feel of an icebound planet. Some kind of outpost here. It's some kind of camouflage mesh. Maybe it's supposed to cover this this stuff from sight from above, you know. These snow-covered tarps are covering more machinery or supplies, maybe ammunition. Absolutely gorgeous. Well, I think this is a good place to end our wander on Hoth for today. But there are more Star Wars planets yet to be visited, so I look forward to seeing you for our next wander. Far, far away. Thanks.